U.S. President Donald Trump signed Republicans' massive $1.5 trillion US dollars, $2 trillion, tax overhaul into law on Friday, cementing the biggest legislative victory of his first year in office, and also approved a short-term spending bill that averts a possible government shutdown. Trump said he wanted to sign the tax bill before leaving Washington for his Mar-a-Lago estate in Florida, rather than stage a more formal ceremony in January, so he could keep his promise to finish work before Christmas. "I didn't want you folks to say I wasn't keeping my promise. I'm keeping my promise," he told reporters in the White House. The two pieces of legislation represent Trump's most significant accomplishment with Congress since taking office in January, as well as a sign of what awaits when he returns from Florida after the Christmas holiday. Read more here. The UN Security Council on Friday unanimously imposed new sanctions on North Korea following its latest intercontinental ballistic missile test, a move that analysts said could have a significant impact on the isolated country's struggling economy. The resolution seeks to ban nearly 90% of refined petroleum product exports to North Korea by capping them at 500,000 barrels a year and, in what diplomats said was a last-minute change, demands the repatriation of North Koreans working abroad within 24 months, instead of 12 months as first proposed. The US-drafted resolution would also cap crude oil supplies to North Korea at 4 million barrels a year. The United States has been calling on China to limit its oil supply to its neighbor and ally. Read more here. French gourmets were celebrating on Friday after a wild truffle was discovered for what experts said was the first time ever in Paris. The discovery in a hotel roof garden in the shadow of the Eiffel Tower comes as prices for the aromatic fungus have doubled to more than 5,000 euro, $8,000, a kilo. Coming just before Christmas, when truffles are used to flavor such seasonal dishes as foie gras and chestnut soup, it raises the hope of an undreamed-of windfall for the new wave of urban gardeners colonizing city roofs. Read more here. iPhone users have begun racing to courthouses, infuriated by an Apple software update that slowed down the operation of their smartphones. At least two groups of customers sued Apple over the deterioration of their phone's performance. One group, in Chicago federal court, claims the software updates that throttle down the performance of iPhone 5, iPhone 6, and some iPhone 7s were intentionally put out to induce customers to buy newer iPhones such as iPhone 8 and iPhone X. Read more here. Bitcoin plunged by 30% to below $12,000 on Friday, December 22, as investors dumped the cryptocurrency after its sharp rise to a peak close to $20,000 prompted warnings by experts of a bubble. After falling to as low as $11,159, it recouped some losses to trade above $14,000 on the Bitstamp platform, down 9% on the day. It is down around 25% this week, its largest weekly loss since April 2013. It kept a brutal week that had been touted as a new era of mainstream trading for the digital currency when Bitcoin futures debuted on CME Group, the world's largest derivatives market, on Sunday.